Joining us from Los Angeles to help us make sense of it all is the award-winning director who made Monsters Ball, Finding Neverland, Stranger Than Fiction, and the new James Bond film, Quantum of Solace. It's Mark Forster. Welcome to The Loop, Mark.
Oh, thanks, Kevin.
All right, so you're a filmmaker who's shown a ton of range, but you've never done anything like a James Bond film. So what exactly attracted you to Quantum of Solace?
To begin with, I saw Casino Royale and I was just like incredibly impressed about Daniel Craig, how he humanized that character and how incredible, you know, three-dimensional the character became, and I could really connect with him. So I thought at first, actually, I didn't want to do it, and the reason was why is because Casino Royale was such a huge hit, and I felt like the pressure to do the follow-up to that would be so enormous that I felt like I didn't want to really like spend a whole year with this incredible amount of pressure of doing a movie like that and not knowing if it could really live up to the expectations. But ultimately, I turned around and changed my mind because I felt like first there was a challenge, and on the other hand, I felt like Daniel Craig would give me the opportunity to, you know, go deeper into the character and work with him and figure out that there's still so much more one can do with that.
Well, Daniel Craig's Casino Royale, it really set an entirely new tone for the Bond film. So how does that carry through in your film?
I love the tone that was set in Casino Royale to make it much more realistic. And, you know, tonally, I kept it in that style to keep it very realistic. But I, like, sort of visually, I changed it quite a bit because on one hand, I wanted to do sort of like a retro Bond, sort of a bit of a throwback to the 60s because I love those early Bonds. And the production design remind us a little bit about that time. But then I juxtaposed that sort of look to sort of a modernized look as well. Like, changed MI6, modernized it, and it's all a little bit more futuristic in that sense. So I juxtaposed those two looks, and in a sense, also I tried to like the backdrop. I felt like should be slightly political, even though James Bond films aren't political movies at all, and they're here for action adventure. I felt like if I make it slightly political, and there's so much interesting stuff going on in the world right now, then it sort of gravitates more to reality, and we could like connect even more with Bond.
So I have to ask, how do your Bond girls hold their own against a guy like Daniel Craig?
You know, they were amazing because I really made sure that, you know, I saw so many girls, and I made sure that two of them I chose, Olga Kurylenko and Gemma Arterton, were both really were able to, you know, hold up with the acting skills and against Daniel, because the thing is, if it had to be, it was important for me that there's this equality about them. And the thing is, you know, today you can't just cast a Bond girl anymore, which is purely an object of beauty. It has to be a three-dimensional character, and there have to be like a weight to it in their performance as well. So I brought a lot of the girls in and had them read with Daniel and tested them like that, and then ultimately I decided for Olga and Gemma.
Well, action films are new to you, Mark, so what are some of the challenges that you found with the film stunts? Were you prepared for everything?
With the stunts, it's basically, you know, I haven't done an action film before, so I was really keen to make the action as incredible and interesting and engaging as possible. But at the same time, I thought it was important throughout the action of the movie to have like an emotional connection to Daniel's character, even in the action sequences. So Daniel is a very physical actor, and he did a lot of stunts himself, which, you know, helps me as a director because I don't have to shoot around the stunt double, and I can shoot more with him, which you know, connects the audience automatically much more with the character because it can be more intense. But you know, everything pretty much, you know, was I sat down with the stunt coordinator or the second unit director and like went through sort of the ideas I had and what I wanted to do, and basically we all took it from there, and it was very collaborative. But at the same time, for me, so my idea was to have like four, like the big action sequences, to set them sort of in the four elements, like water, fire, air and earth, and have like a water sequence, the air sequence, a fire sequence, and so on. And and that was sort of my sort of overall idea. And then there are a couple of smaller action sequences in between, which were also fun to do.
Well, thanks for joining us in The Loop, Mark. Quantum of Solace opens in theaters this Friday, and I don't have to tell our fans, they're going to go see it, but go see it.